Namaste and good evening to everyone. There is a very beautiful verse in Sri Ramana's Upadesha Saram which describes the nature of our soul, of ourself, which is Kin Surupam Iti Atma Darshani Avyaya Bhav Purna Chitta Sukham. Translation is, what is the nature of ourself, of our soul? It is immutable, birthless, full of happiness, joy, and bliss. This verse confirms the joy and the happiness and the peace of what we are, you know. But in spite of this confirmation, why is it that we do not feel that the bliss or the joy or the happiness is a daily part of us? Why is it that we experience periods of distress, agitation, restlessness, violence, disharmony, and a lot of fear in our life? The reason is, in my understanding, is that we are stuck in words. Words that we listen, see, read, and contemplate, introspect, are just images and ideas of the truth. They're not the truth itself. And therefore, we need to get out of words to and move into the experience of it. We have to somehow become more interested in the experience of what has been told rather than the words itself. Much like the word mango depicts an image, but it can never give us the experience of what it is to actually eat a mango, right? Of course, words that we listen to, get inspired, do give us a direction, and they're helpful to us, but it's much like a map that can give us direction, but it cannot give us the experience or the walk itself. So we must try to get out of the comforts that words provide us and try to move into the experience of what the speaker is trying to talk about. How are we going to achieve it? So first few things you have to put in your life. First thing is, become less interested in reading and listening to things, and try to get more and more involved, try to get more and more knowledge about how you can attain that knowledge through your own self. Okay, so for that, what we have to do is, we have to involve ourselves in a sitting meditation, formal sitting meditation of at least 1 hour a day. We can split that 1 hour into two sessions, one in the morning and one at night. That is ideal. And move within ourselves. That's the first thing that we have to do religiously every day of our life. The second thing that we have to do is, we have to maintain, we have to try to create a very deep relationship with our spine. I always say, either you are in the spine or in the mind. If you're in the mind, then the agitation, restlessness, and chaos will be part of your experience. But if you're in the spine, then you will experience a joy manifold that you will feel in your life. And why is that so? Because in the spine, there is a nerve which is called Sushumna Nadi. This thin thread-like nerve that moves from the base to the top of your head, develop a relationship with that. You sit with it and breathe into the Sushumna Nadi. Learn it from someone who knows about how to do that, and you will see that your life will become to transform in a very blissful manner in everything. The third thing is, don't listen to your mind who says that you have more important things to do and that you don't have time to sit for your meditation. The mind will always bring this kind of, it always trick you with all these things. So be very careful about it. Even if you're the most busiest person in the world, always spend time, get some time out for yoga and meditation, 1 hour a day, and you will see that a lot of change will dramatically happen in your life, and that mental knowingness of what you read in your books will be translated, will be converted into the actual realization. And that's where the whole thing is, the real thing is.